person who walks into a grocery or big box store, looks at all the shelves brimming with products, notices the massive quantity of packaging, and gets upset at all that waste, you probably won't like the story. While you've been dutifully separating your recycling from your trash, the US has been exporting your recyclables as scrap, largely to China. We don't turn your old yogurt cups into new ones. China has been turning them into things like electronics parts. So the US has been exporting millions of tons of scrap to them every year for billions of dollars. But this year, that changed. China has implemented something called Operation Green Fence, which bans the import of most garbage. It was supposed to end in November of 2013, but Chinese industry sources now say that Green Fence is here to stay. China did this to help curb the growing giant mountains of trash they have. Some heaps are as big as 8 stories high. As a result of Green Fence, they've stopped importing everything but the cleanest, properly sorted, recyclable scrap. They've stopped taking plastics with recycling codes 3 through 7 altogether. So if you see one of these signs on that piece of plastic garbage that you just carefully cleaned and put into your recycling bin, chances are it's heading straight into a landfill. Because unlike China, we haven't developed the industry to turn much of our recycling into anything usable at all. And until we do, much of your recyclables will continue to end up in landfills. Because God forbid, we should consider not making tiny plastic cups for individual servings of yogurt. God forbid, we should consider alternative packaging solutions, like the one a company called Ecovative Design developed. They're taking local farm waste and mixing it with tissues from mushrooms and actually growing replacements for plastic foams used in packaging. Imagine that, natural packaging. Natural, fast decomposition. But that's not what big corporations are focusing on. So when it comes to our recycling ending up in landfills, let's not blame the Chinese for no longer taking our garbage. Let's blame a system that packages and sells us what's really at fault. Rampant, irresponsible consumerism. Tonight, let's talk about that by following me on Twitter at TheResident.